everyone, this is Dr. Kazi, and in this video, we are going to learn about the upper limb regions, then the pectoral region, and finally, the general anatomy of the breast. Now, we know that the whole upper limb is divided into 7 main regions, starting with the shoulder, which consists of the clavicle bone, the beauty bone, and the scapula. Then in the arm, we have the humerus bone, and the cubital fossa, which is present in front of your elbow joint. The forearm consists of the radius on the lateral side, and on the medial side, we have the ulna bone. The forearm, 2 bones, the radius and the ulna bone. Then in the wrist, we have the carpal and the metacarpal bones in the hands and the phalanges. Now, let's discuss about the shoulder region, why it is very, very important in the upper limb anatomy. The shoulder region connects the upper limb, your upper appendages, with this trunk. That is why the shoulder is very important. It is divided into 3 main parts: the scapular part, the pectoral part, and the axilla part. The pectoral part is further divided into 2 main muscles or regions: the thoracoappendicular muscle and the breast. Now, what is the thoracoappendicular muscle? Have a look at this diagram. The thoracoappendicular muscles are 4 muscles which are present on the front side of your thorax and on the lateral side. Have a look. Below the clavicle muscle, we have the subclavius muscle. Sub means below, and the clavius means it is below the clavicle bone. That is why it is known as the subclavius muscle. So we have 4 muscles: the subclavius pectoralis major, pectoralis minor, and the serratus anterior. Now, have a look. The pectoralis major muscle is the most prominent muscle in your chest cavity, this one. If you remove this pectoralis major muscle, you have the pectoralis minor muscle. This muscle is smaller as comparison to the pectoralis major muscle. And then you have the serratus anterior. This muscle, the serratus anterior, is attached with the scapular bone as well as the ribs. Now, we are done with the thoracoappendicular muscle. Let's talk about breast. What are the breasts? The breasts are specialized accessory glands which are present on the skin, and it releases milk in case of females. Now, the structure of breast in immature female and males is very similar, but after puberty, there are certain changes in the female breast. What are those changes? Have a look. The breast of the female enlarges by the action of hormones, the female hormones, ovarian hormones. It assumes the hemispherical or dome shape, and the ducts elongation by the action of hormone. And finally, we have the fat deposition in the breast. That is why in young female, the breast protrudes forward because of these 4 changes after the puberty. Now, the question is why we study breast in the upper limb anatomy? Because on the lateral side, we have certain arteries which are supplying the structure of the breast, and the arteries are in relation with the upper limb. On the medial side of the breast, we have the blood supply from the chest cavity. So we can study the breast in the thorax anatomy as well as in the upper limb anatomy. Strictly speaking, the breast is not the part of your upper limb. It is the part of the thorax. Why we study it in the upper limb anatomy? Because the blood supply and the lymphatic drainage is associated with the upper limb anatomy. Now, what is the location of the breast? The location of breast is not fixed. It is variable because generally the breast is between the 2nd rib and the 6th rib. Have a look at this diagram. It is between the 2nd and the 6th rib. The nipple is approximately at the region of 5th rib. In the next video, we are going to learn about the structure of the breast, the blood and the lymph supply of the breast. Please do like, share and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.